so many faces, especially on a tough night like this. I want to thank you for coming out this evening. My name is Dave Green. I've been running Council 1, District 1 for Cuyahoga County Council. And I've had an opportunity to speak to various groups throughout the county, and a lot of groups have come and asked me to speak about what they should look for as they screen candidates to vote for the upcoming election. The three things I always focus on is, number one, experience, number two is vision, number three, a track record of being able to implement that vision and working through the problems and challenges. Now, what I bring is somewhat unique to the table, and that I've already been through this process of reforming government once before. So I have a very unique, relevant set of experiences to bring to the county council. I was involved with the formation and founding of the largest city in the country ever to incorporate back in a suburb of Atlanta. We're a city of 100,000 people with nearly $100 million operating budget. We started that city from scratch. We broke away, I say broke away, we didn't become a separate county, but our county was providing our services very much as a township does it here in Ohio, and we weren't receiving our fair share of services. So we decided, well, it was a 35-year struggle, I was involved in it all 35 years, the last few years, to form our own city. And I was fortunate to be engaged as a board member and treasurer of the referendum committee, lobbying the legislature to grant us the right to have that vote, which we were successful once the Republicans gained control of the House and the Senate and the state, as well as gaining control of the governor's mansion. So we became, we got the right to vote. We had roughly 60 days to educate our constituency as to why it was important that we form a city. We did that. We actually had a 93% approval rate, very similar to what we had here in Cuyahoga County with 66%. Anything over 10% in election terms is a landslide. So both communities had landslide elections to move toward reform. And that's the level of experience I want to bring here. The other thing I talked about is vision. And obviously, it doesn't take having lived here a long time for your entire life to understand that we've got an ethical problem going on here in the county today's anniversary of the corruption scandal breaking. So what I've done is early on in my campaign, about 10 days after I declared back in March, is I came out with an ethics ordinance, an actual ordinance that we passed back in Georgia that's been modified and presented to the Transition Advisory Group Ethics Committee is studying. It's one of their 13 initiatives. And it's important that we set the tone early on as to what the residents can expect in county government, what our employees, what our elected officials, appointed officials, and volunteers in the county know what the boundaries are, both good and bad. A few weeks ago, I came out with a proposal to create an Office of Independent Inspector General to help aid and assist in the detection and prevention of fraud and corruption, to work on providing suggesting efficiencies in government to help reducing wasteful spending. Both those initiatives have been received very well. The ethics ordinance actually has been picked up nationally by Yahoo, and we're very proud of that. On the jobs front, it's the second item I see we need to focus here in Ohio. I've been working with Representative Baker on House Bill 437, which is a concept I presented to her back in October to help create jobs in Ohio. And I presented that in October before I even considered running for office, just because I want to see the state as a great state, a great team, and want to see us succeed and compete nationally and internationally. Locally, I've been able to present the concept of sharpening the Economic Development Department's vision to really focus on creating jobs, both within our communities instead of moving companies from one city to another. And finally, efficiencies in government. Obviously, the Inspector General concept is a move in that direction. So I see that hook man's coming. So I appreciate your time. I appreciate your support. I am the endorsed candidate by the Republican Party. And just this past week, I was honored to be endorsed candidate by the Plain Dealer. I'm proud of both those distinctions. And thank you very much for your time. I look forward to it.